Hello there and welcome. I'm Ole Brøgger, and if you're new here, I really hope I'll earn your subscription today. Today, we're going to have another look at this longer B140 watt diode laser. And we are going to make it longer using these extensions. And I'm going to build an enclosure for the whole setup so we can get a better airflow. We better get started. Before I start disassembling the machine, I have cut out these brackets and they will be used to lock down the machine when it's in the enclosure. And we will get back to those later. I'll need to take this machine apart, and the first thing I'm going to do is to remove the laser head because I don't want to do any damage to that. Now we can detach the cables, and this limit switch can stay, but we have to remove this one because we're going to use that on the extension. Now we can put these away and mount these cables. I think it's very nice they made room to put the cables inside the frame. We don't want this to be a way for the rollers on the X-axis. We also need to switch out this adapter board with the one that came with this extension set. I'll save this and put it away if I decide that I would like to switch back to a shorter version of this machine. Let's put that thing there and see if we can put this back on the right way. It's really hard to work with this thing on my small table because it's so big. And while it is here in this position, I think I will mount the screws for the backside. I made a huge mistake in my previous video. I said something wrong. The long ones are going through the top and the short ones are going through the end. Let's see if we can flip this around and mount this one. Okay, I'll have to put this over the edge of the table in the other end. Sorry, you can't see that because this is very long. Oh, I'm very excited about this cutting area. I think I'll try to put a zip tie in here somehow, and I don't want this cable to conflict with the belt. I think this will work. And now it's time to flip it all the way around again. And a note here, I haven't attached any cables to the motors yet, because if you're sliding, you actually provide energy and that can go right back into the circuit board and you can fry it. Don't attach any cables until everything is assembled. Need to make sure that it is attached correctly in here on this motor wheel. And it's time to flip it once again. And we are almost done. We just need to attach the final cables and do some cable management. I think I might have put this the wrong way. Well, sometime that happens. Okay, deattach the belts and roll off this one. I think I'll do it. Yeah, I need to do it from the back end. I'm glad I didn't tighten all these belts because then I had to loosen them again. Lucky this is a pretty easy fix, and I must say working with this machine is actually pretty easy. I can easily remove the belts. Just read the manual carefully and pay attention to what you're doing. I'm sometimes a fool, I rush things and I don't read the assembly guide or manuals. I just want to see the logic in things and do them by myself, and that's when mistakes happen. Now we can put this back in. Again, remember, small screws in the ends and long screws on the top. That's when you don't read the manual or pay attention to things in the manual. Because it was saying right there where to put them. I think I'll need to put the laser head on itself because then I can attach and measure the length of the cables. And remember to put the zip ties loose because you don't want to squeeze this silicone hose.
I just went out here to my workshop and now it's time to clean up the rest. I already moved most of the stuff around here because I want the longer laser to be over here in its new enclosure. And I don't want to get rid of my K40 laser here because it can still do some very good tasks that a diode laser can't do. I just need to find another space for it. But for now, I'll just pack it away and then I will see where I can get room for it. Now the K40 is gone. I'll still keep this as my vent. It didn't move far. It's right over here. And we got the longer right here. I need to cut a base plate for the enclosure that will be right here. I have this piece of MDF. It is 120 by 80 centimeters and I need to make a cut that is 72. This is the frames I cut so I can lock it down here on these feet. I use this piece of cutoff so I can make sure that everything is straight and it will just stay flush up against this bracket and this will be totally level. This is the cutoff I had from the bottom plate and I just chopped it off here in the ends and screwed it in from the bottom. I also cut a back panel which is going here in the back. I have attached one side panel and the back panel and the top panel. And now I need to plug in the laser because I need to mark up some stuff and actually cut a hole in the bottom here. I have just made a box with a line of the maximum cut size and now I will try to frame it out here. This is our max cutting area. It made a very beautiful line here. Perfect. I made a frame cut that is 450 by 450 millimeters. And I will cut out that section here. And then I'm going to make a vault for airflow. And when I'm going to use the rotary tool, so I don't have to adjust the height here on the laser and the legs. I can just put the rotary tool into the vault. Now that I am going to cut through here, I will need to make some precautions because I don't want to hit the stuff down here. So I hope I can manage to put this here just to protect the stuff down here when we are going to cut. I hope it won't melt my garbage can down here. Yeah, it hits my garbage can, but it's so far away, it's out of focus and it won't burn it. I think we are going to need another pass. I actually don't know what happened, but it went out of alignment here. I had to run it a couple of times. Oh my god, it's scorched. That is why we need airflow. I cut all these pieces on my saw. It was a bit quicker than cutting them on the laser. And this will be the walls for, yeah, I can call it the walls. And the last piece is here. And we're going to mount the fan from the original cover from longer. Hopefully this will be the last cut I have to make without proper ventilation. Maybe I should just try to press it out. The fan is installed and now we just need to put this box together. I'm using some wood glue just to make sure that it will be airtight. I'm using these corner clamps and then it's pretty easy to let the stuff hold itself and put in a screw. Box assembled, glued, and now I can remove this last corner. This is the other side panel. I want the buttons from the laser cutter to be outside this enclosure. So I'll have to cut this out and figure out how I will make it airtight underneath. We need to put something in here. This is window sealer and I will put that all around the edge. The reason why I'm using this is because I don't want to do any kind of modifications to the laser frame itself, glue anything to it. It should be able to be removed without any kind of harm. I think this will give it a pretty tight seal all around. Now I just have to figure out what to do down here, but I think I'll just put some foam. This is the packaging the laser came in, and this part is where the front was, and then I can just cut it out and it will seal perfectly underneath. Everything here is sealed up, and now I'll just put some duct tape here just to make sure that everything is airtight. This was the light that came with my other enclosure for my other laser cutter, and this is the one that came with the longer. And I will install both of them because light, you can't have enough of it. I have installed the lights up here. Now I just need to do some cable management. This is some cutoffs I had from a 6mm MDF. It wasn't quite big enough, but it doesn't matter because I can actually use this as the lid. And then this part will be permanent. And then we have a lid. This is screwed in and sealed. And now I just need to attach some wood here and here so I can get a good seal when the lid is closing. I will use this window sealer again.
I also use window sealer on top of the walls, and then I installed the walls in the bottom of the enclosure.
I bought this safety glass and it is rated for lasers in 405 to 560, so it should be safe and I won't need my safety glasses. I also got these tiles. They're ceramic and I will put them here in the bottom just to make sure that the laser won't burn through the wood. This is the window. I want it to be approximately here. I will cut it with the laser and make two cuts. I will make one that hopefully will pass only halfway through the wood and the other one will cut right through it.
I'll try to cut in a depth of 3mm, but it's very hard. But at least it's easy to work with MDF because it's so soft.
After a lot of work with a knife and sandpaper, I finally succeeded in making this groove here. And now the safety glass fits perfectly here. I have put in some hinges and made some support here in the bottom. Now we can install this piece of glass. It's not quite a press fit, so I will have to put some adhesive along the edge, but I think that'll do.
And I'm finally done building this enclosure for my longer B1 40 watt diode laser. It doesn't look pretty, it looks like a cardboard box that's taped together, but it works and that's the most important thing. I had to build this in a hurry and my time was limited, and obviously that's why it's not painted. But I have some projects coming up where I need this laser because I have a session for my D&D campaign very soon, and I need some stuff for that. I also built a couple of things on this enclosure off camera, and I will show it. First, I put this thread with an eye hook and a screw, and I installed a magnet. I also put up an extra monitor and a real keyboard instead of using the laptop, and I just got a cheap mouse because it's very dusty out here, and if it breaks, I have some extra in store. Over here, I made a shelf for the air assists, and I have full control here with power, emergency stop, and everything. I can access everything very easily. And about the ventilation, here I didn't put any seal, and there is a seal in each side which gives me a gap all the way over this that is about 5 millimeters wide, and now the air can be sucked in here and down in the vaults and outside, and it actually works pretty good. And this laser, it's just awesome. I made a couple of engravings and cuts. I made some name tags for my colleagues at work for their desk. That turned out pretty good. And because of good airflow, there is no scorching or burns or anything, and it's totally clean. There's no soot anywhere. And a huge shout out and thank you to Longer for sending me this laser cutter. I really appreciate it a lot. And if you're interested in a laser like this, I have a couple of affiliate links down below. So you just click that and you can own one of these awesome lasers. This is it for now. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you soon.